Welcome back to our MSense digital event. By the way, we are broadcasting live to you here for 3 days from Regensburg, from our brand new CCC, our co-creation center. We're at the headquarters of MR in Regensburg, and I want to present you now a world premiere. Special surprise, the world premiere of the MSense VAM, the Vibroacoustic Online Monitoring. To present this, I have my next two guests here. Their names are Bastian Fischer and Christian Buchner. Let me begin with Christian. Christian, he's part of the MR family for more than 10 years now, and he has gathered a lot of experience with monitoring system throughout his time. And Bastian is working for Enhausen for over 3 years now, and he's the head of our business development in the automation department. So together they will present how to detect mechanical and electrical irregularities on the tap changer early, right now. So please welcome them up here on our presentation stage.
Thank you, Peter, for the warm welcome. It's really a great opportunity to share with you, all of the audience out there in all our time zones, our world premiere MSense Vibroacoustic Monitoring, which allows you to detect early any mechanical or electrical irregularities. For that purpose, I'd like to change over to our presentation. And we'll give you some background on the motivation why we do vibroacoustic and OLTC monitoring. As you know, our transformers are the most critical asset in the network. They are facing with two key changes. First, they get older and older. Second, the load, the volatile load coming from renewable energy is increasing at a fast pace. That criticality comes down to the reliability of the OLTC, which is the single most critical part of the transformer. Furthermore, that is the single mechanical part of the transformer, which works like a clockwork, requires constant, regular maintenance from experts. And with that, we also want to ensure that perfect reliability through a constant monitoring. This constant monitoring is done in various ways. It aims at extending and establishing new maintenance practices, such as the condition-based maintenance, which allows you to extend the maintenance periods of the OLTC as much as possible. It includes self-monitoring to ensure that the switch is working in perfect condition without any disturbances. The monitoring also gives us more flexibility in the utilization of the transformer, which on one side increases the load and the performance, and on the other side reduces the cost. Now, with that constant monitoring of the OLTC, we aim at maximum availability and avoiding any unplanned disturbances or any unplanned irregularities on the OLTC. For that, we have multiple monitoring principles which we are using on the OLTC. The first principle is to ensure the contacts and the mechanical wear is in good shape. For that, MR has been providing for a long time the oil tap, tap guard, and various monitoring capabilities. The second aspect is to monitor the entire mechanical part, which gives you a good understanding on the wear and tear of the motor drive unit, of the shaft, of the mechanical parts of the OLTC. Now, that's not the entire view. We are missing a dimension by only looking at the mechanical side, which, by the way, we can do with traditional MCI or with more advanced real-time torque and position monitoring. There's one aspect which goes undetected, that are very subtle, very small torque events which are not recognized because there is an overlay of the maximum force in that mechanical system. Therefore, in order to detect those subtle, very little irregularities, we are introducing the online vibroacoustic monitoring, which allows us to look inside, literally to look inside the OLTC. With that deep view and monitoring of the OLTC, we recognize the mechanical, very subtle mechanical deviations, as well as we are able to literally listen to the electrical contact system. Today, we are focusing on introducing that world premiere of MSense VAM, the vibroacoustic online monitoring. I'd like at that time to give you a really strong attention prior to introducing my colleague Christian Buchner, who will be looking into details with you on the MSense VAM system.
Thank you, Bastian, for this introduction, and a warm welcome from my side.
Du musst tickern. Einmal nach rechts.
Enter a new dimension of reliability with our MSense VAM, the heartbeat of the transformer. The heartbeat is the mechanical acoustic sound the tap changer generates during the switching operation. With this mechanical or with this acoustic signal and our self-made, self-developed software, we are able to intervene and prevent serious incident into the tap changer. It's an online monitoring system available 24/7, installed once during the at the OEM or for a retrofit, and working for a normal lifetime of 15 years on the transformer, depending on the environmental condition. This monitoring system should not substitute the other monitorings, like our torque monitoring or motor current index. It should complete the tap changer monitoring. Because each monitoring system has its own focus on the individual parts of the tap changer. The installation of the MSense VAM is very easy. By removing a bolt from the head cover, the MSense VAM sensor could be installed on the head cover. It's a stainless steel holder for the sensor, which is very robust for temperatures and also for environmental influences. The connection from the sensor to the motor drive unit or to the ETOS is done with one cable and connected to a special measurement card We called it the VI4 card, which is especially developed for these vibroacoustic signals. The CPU, it's normally, or with the ETOS already there, so there is no need to install a second CPU card. The existing CPU card could be used. There needs to be installed a temperature measurement card, because the temperature of the transformer or the tap changer oil has influences on the behavior of this acoustical curve. Furthermore, we need an I/O card, a digital I/O card, to be able to measure the tap position and give some alarm statuses out via hardwire signals. The installation for onboard tap changers, of course, looks a little bit different. This example, what we have here on the picture, is only for our intake tap changers, which we produce in Germany. And of course, this solution is available for a one column solution, as well as for three column solution. So as an orientation, we say for each motor drive unit, we need our own VIM sensor. So that means, for example, for a bench parallel operation, we need to have three sensors, three VIM sensors. How does this signal looks like? Here on the lower left corner, you see this high frequency vibroacoustic signal, which is generated during the switch operation. And to make it visible or to be able to work with, we will create an envelope curve of these high frequency signals, which you see in the middle now in this blue curve. The yellow curve is the limit value curve, which is implemented with a self-learning algorithm and narrowing to the envelope curve with each switching operation. At the third step, we are offering an optional step. We are offering an offline interpretation of these online data, which allows us to identify the root cause of the problems. Whereas if we see the step two, we are only able to indicate there is any problem, but with the offline interpretation, we are able to say concrete where this problem could occur or is. The sensor itself, I said already, is made of stainless steel with some protection around the sensor. The sensor itself is only this small part with the MR logo on. And the holder for this sensor is now shown for the intake. As I said already, for RMV, for onboard or third-party tap changes, it could look a little bit different. The trigger for this signal comes from our running contacts, from the motor drive unit, the K1, K2 contacts, with a plus minus 2 seconds before and after the switching signal to be able to indicate the background noises and the disturbing noises on the tap changer. Furthermore, the oil temperature and the tap position will be indicated, and the signal transferred with electromagnetic robust signal called IEPE standard. The signal itself has a sampling rate of 50 kilohertz in the frequency range of 10 to 20 kilohertz. To give you an orientation, the human voice is around 200 to 5 kilohertz frequency. So the measurement of this sensor is higher, on a higher frequency band. Here in these examples, you see the influence of the different switching clusters. That means each tap position has his own switching cluster and own fibroacoustical typical shape and wave. To point out the violet curve, you see that between 2 and 3 seconds, there is a higher amplitude compared to the other signals. The rest of the signal is more or less similar, with some slight time frequent shift, which could come from different reasons. In the first delivery, the limit value curve looks like this. It's not active yet. It's a kind of straight curve on the top of this frequency band. And each tap, each cluster needs to be learned in a learning phase during the operation or during the installation in with FAT or SAT test. So normally it takes around about 10 switching operations to get this limit value curve active. Here we have around about 5 switching operations done until this self-learning process is finished. Then the yellow shape is very narrow to the envelope curve of the original acoustic pattern signal. If it's installed as a retrofit, you can do this self-learning algorithm or self-learning curves manually as well. Therefore, you need to switch these depositions manually with the motor drive unit. The advantage of this self-learning algorithm is that it's independent of the type of tap changer and independent of the transformer the M-Sense WAM sensor is installed. You can imagine that the on-ball tap changer has a different acoustic pattern than an in-ball tap changer. But for the software, it doesn't matter. The self-learning algorithm and the mathematical algorithm in the software is able to handle these differences. For the event generation, we have 3 categories or 3 criteria. So the first one is that the limit value curve needs to be violated from the envelope curve 3 times in a row. 3 times because we want to exclude some external interferences or disturbances with this counting of 3 times in a row violating the limit value curve. The second criteria is that the amplitude of the envelope curve changed by more than 10 decibel. And the third one is that the time sequence changed more than 300 milliseconds. As well, we have, of course, we have a plausibility check. If the vibroacoustic signal is not valid or is lost, then gray alarms will be generated. So there will be explicit no red alarms, no interaction or no blocking of the motor drive unit as we have it with the torque monitoring, for example. The offline interpretation of the online data could be done either via a direct access from our side to the device with a modem or with a download from the raw data and sent to our database via the web portal, the MR portal. And in the database, our experts are able to compare the patterns over the time. And even if we have an original measurement pattern from our factory, they are able to compare the pattern over the time with the very first one to be able to indicate slow-moving failures. This, of course, could not be done online. This needs to be done offline. The result of this interpretation will be then a probable report with clear recommendations for you as the operator of the tap changer and transformer. Here an example how this report could look like. Of course, you have master data in there, transformer and tap changer data, and there will be explicit be detailed report of the events and the data, and summary and recommendation with some nice pictures. And if there are some special events or some special happenings, of course, this report could vary from, let's say, very basic to extended information of this report. Here's some concrete examples, what we already figured out with this monitoring. First example is the spring. A weekend spring has a different time sequence than a new spring. Of course, the new spring is faster, the weekend spring is slower. This we could indicate with online fibroacoustic, as well as some chattering noises from some contacts or from the selector or the diverter switch insert, as well as some synchronization errors from the diverter switch to the motor drive unit. Finally, a very nice example. What we figured out with this offline interpretation, after the alarm and recommendation to open the tap changer, they found a tap changer rusty from the entire diverter switch insert. Also, the shell of the insert was very rusty. And yeah, nice example and showcase for this working online fiber acoustic measurement. For the conclusion, I will hand over again to my colleague, Bastian. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Christian. We truly enter a new dimension of reliability. As Christian explained, we are now able to combine multiple monitoring principles into one cohesive system, comparing the forces of the torque measurement with the vibroacoustic pattern of MSense online measurement, online monitoring. Now, one thing is really important. We need to combine those principles in order to give you the most insight, the most early indication that a component of the OLTC might be showing some irregularities. Now, earlier you can detect those irregularities, better you are prepared. And therefore, on the next couple of slides, I'd like to describe the complementarity of torque and VAM monitoring. Here we have a typical torque curve over the switching operation, which clearly displays the moment, the torque moments created by the different mechanical parts of the system. Now, as you can see, the curve displays the maximum. There are areas of the switching operation which go undetected because either there is no torque or the torque deviation is so little, so subtle, that the torque monitoring will not recognize it. Therefore, we use online VAM, which is able to capture those subtle changes. And as Christian explained, each and every principle is supervised and monitored and has its own thresholds, limit values, and validation rules. As you can see, that's exactly the same picture. The VAM curve in blue is below the shadow or the envelope curve, which represents the dynamically learned area which is acceptable for that system. If we now superimpose the torque curve in green and the VAM curve in blue, you clearly recognize that those two patterns cover the entire switching operation. And even on the far left, as there is no torque, VAM recognizes the permissible vibration area. Or on the far right, when there is the operation of the switching step, you see there is no torque. It's going down to zero, but there's a high vibration impact shown by the blue peak. Here, collectively, all curves together with their respective thresholds and limit values. Now, that clearly demonstrates you need torque and VAM to monitor the entire operation. Now, there's an additional aspect. So far, we have discussed the regular operation in your network. Now, before the OLTC and the transformer gets to your place, it needs to get through the entire supply chain and through the different service steps. And during that phase, from the cradle to the substation, we also monitor the different values. We keep track, we fingerprint, we keep track at MR during manufacturing of the permissible torque and VAM signature, which is represented in the middle. We at MR, before leaving the factory, we keep track of those data. Now, that OLTC goes on a truck or on a train and needs to be shipped to the OEM. For that shipment, typically we recommend to install the MLOC on the OLTC, ensuring that also during transportation we can record and log the G-forces of that device. Once the OLTC is installed at the transformer, at the OEM does its testing, its performance insulation winding testing, but performs also the FAT, the factory acceptance test. Doing those steps as well, torque and VAM is stored, is compared. We call that the fingerprint of the OLTC during the entire life cycle of that OLTC. Now, next step, the OLTC gets shipped to the substation. Of course, during that shipment, the entire transformer gets monitored with MLOC as well. Once the transformer is at site on the substation, the EPC connects all the things electrically, performs its testing, connects it to supervisory systems, performs as well a comparison of the torque and VAM values. Finally, the transformer and the OLTC is in normal operation, and you as a TSO, DSO, will run that transformer with the OLTC. Now, it's important to recognize that monitoring is the basis to collect data, to analyze the data, and to prevent and predict irregularities before they happen. Because the next step is, with that prediction, with that recognition of deviations from the norm, we can launch the service and repair step, which allows us to do the needed performance and to put the OLTC and the transformer back into operation with a torque and a VAM signature acceptable for that device in that age with that condition. Therefore, we can also track on how well has the service been done, and has the OLTC and the entire system been returned into a good shape. Now, that literally creates a complete tracking and logging and fingerprinting of the OLTC, of the transformer, as well as of the entire operation in your substation. And with that VAM, MSense, vibroacoustic online monitoring, we truly give you an end-to-end monitoring, health indication, which gives you advanced time and advanced indication to redispatch the substation, to plan for maintenance. Now, as you can imagine, there's several years of experience going into those systems. And that is proven by the many installations we already have in the world. Now, as I indicated, that picture gives you an overview of over 2,500 plus OLTC monitoring systems, which include the motor current index monitoring, the torque monitoring, as well as the first vibroacoustic deployments, which are in all regions of the world, in Europe, in Asia, and on the western side, soon in the Americas. With that, I'd like to give you, the audience, the time for your questions, and at that moment we are going to our, I'm just looking to my colleague, Peter Schelter, who is collecting the answers from you, from your chat area. And let's see what comes first.
We'll begin with the questions, but thank you very much, Bastian. In fact, I have already some questions. The first one is, do you still need a torque monitoring if you use the vibroacoustic monitoring system?
Well, I think I answered this question already in my presentation. Yes and no. You don't need it, but WAM is designed to complement the entire depth changer monitoring. So each monitoring system has its own focus on the individual parts of the depth changer. So yes and no.
And maybe to add to that, thank you, Christian. I think you also have different situations, whether it's a new build, whether it's a retrofit. For a new build, the easiest is to have Torque and WAM by default installed from MR through the OEM because you benefit from that fingerprinting. In addition, if you have retrofit, you can simply plug in, as Christian described, plug in the WAM sensor on one OLTC for any transformer, for all OLTCs in your fleet, and you can make them comparable. You can optimize, you can monitor the performance of your OLTC. Yes?
I think you mentioned a very good point, Bastian. The benefit of WAM is that it's very simple to retrofit because the sensor is very simple to install and the hardware or the electronic components or could be easily installed on a separate cabinet next to the motor drive unit, which could be done within a couple of hours, let's say, compared to the torque monitoring, which is quite complicated because then you need to modify the entire motor drive.
So you already stole my next question, actually. Oh, you gave already the answers. The next question would have been if it is possible to retrofit a transformer with a vibroacoustic sensor. So as you said, it's very simple, very easy to retrofit, to install the sensor at a later time. Is there anything else you would like to add to this point or to this question?
I mean, we have already some experience, especially in the eastern part of the world, where we did some retrofit of MEMS and SWAM, which was very successful. Bastian,
yes.
I mean, you was involved as well in this
project. Typically, customers get trained on the first installation, how to install it together with MR, so all the best practices are communicated to the customer or the EPC, and then they can retrofit it step by step in their fleet on their own. As mentioned, you can do that in live operation because the system is self-learning. It adjusts itself based on artificial intelligence to really define the permissible area based on the specific installation. So it's open, it is self-adaptable and easy retrofittable. Yes.
Thank you very much, both of you. The next question is, can you give an example of a detected anomaly?
Maybe you do WAM, I do Torque.
Yeah.
Christian.
I also think I had some examples in my presentation as well. We found some irregularities in the time sequence and also in the amplitude. And especially the very detailed analysis could be done with the offline interpretation. So therefore, we found these showcases where we found these rusty depth changes. We found some scratching temperature thermometer in the pocket, some loose contacts. So yes, we have already some examples.
Great, thank you. And Bastian, for the Torque?
Sure. Typically on Torque, what we see is that there is a slight misalignment of the OLTC when it's mounted in the transformer, and therefore the Torque limits compared to the limits measured at MR are different, are higher. Therefore, the OEM immediately recognizes, oh, before we put that in production, we readjust the alignment, we ensure the gearing and the shafts are well, well done. That is something we detect very early before it goes into production and avoiding unplanned disturbance. Once it is in production, of course, there's always the possibility of some material defect in the gearing, which goes recognized, and then torque monitoring protects the OLTC. That's really a key feature. Torque monitoring avoids that excess force is put onto the OLTC and damages the OLTC. Therefore, it stops the operation, gives you time to maintain the current power supply. It stops operation, but not the it doesn't trip the transformer, and it gives you time to investigate. So clearly, both systems together help you to get a deep insight and early indication to avoid irregularities or disturbances.
Thank you very much. Another question I received is, what was the motivation to develop this system? So the VAM system and maybe also the torque monitoring system.
Yeah, may I answer this question?
Sure, go ahead.
Some of you know that we are already offering offline vibroacoustic measurement on tap changes since a couple of years. And the feedback what we got from this service and also the results what we got out of these measurements was very, very nice. Actually, this, I think, was in the end, to be honest, I don't know it 100%, but I think this was the motivation to make now this this device or this function online available. And with our ETOS system, it was not a big thing, I suppose, to extend these functionalities of ETOS with this M-Sense VAM sensor.
Exactly, I think you touched the point. It's a difference whether you do diagnostic, offline, one time, once per year diagnostic, or whether you do regular, I mean, minute by minute, operation by minute, operation by operation, monitoring of the OLTC operation, which gives you much more data, which allows you to gain the history and to recognize any deviation from standard much earlier. That together, moving from diagnostic to monitoring and the year-long experiences we have was the motivation. I think to add one aspect, there's one thing you touched on is the integration with ETOS. I think it's important, more dimensions, more aspects you get from your transformer, better is your dynamic health condition, you know, the estimation of the dynamic health condition. And as you have that dynamic health condition in real time, every time, you can make informed decision about how much you load the transformer and when to dispatch and take an outage to make the needed maintenance. I think those are the reasons why we do monitoring.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
So thank you very much, Christian and Bastian, for these really deep insights into the monitoring of on-load tap changers. Our experts in the chat are available throughout the whole day and the next days as well. So please come back at 5 o'clock for our question and answer round. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Happy to be there.
Thank you, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
See you soon.